As we praise him today, he leads us to the throne of God where he carries out the promises and fulfills the dreams of our life. Because it's from his throne that God executes his righteousness and his justice in the earth. Psalms 145 says, I will extol you, O my God, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you and I will praise your name forever. All your works shall praise you, O Lord, and your saints shall bless you. They shall speak of your glory, and they will talk of your power. To make known to the sons of men your mighty acts and the glorious majesty of your kingdom. For your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout all generations. The Lord upholds all who fall and raises up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look expectantly upon you, Lord, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all of his ways, gracious in all of his works. He's near to all who call upon him. And to all who call upon him in truth, he will fulfill the desires of them who fear him. Right now, I just want you to get ready to begin to declare how mighty God is in your life. The psalmist said he is mighty to save. He's victorious over you today. There's no enemy he hasn't conquered. So no matter what you're facing right now, no matter what name it is called by, whether it be cancer, divorce, marital issues, addiction, financial loss, no cash flow, whatever it is that you may be struggling with today, it has a name, but his name is above every name. So that at the name of Jesus, every knee bows and every tongue confesses he's Lord. So I just want you right now, every day when I pray, I make faith declarations. I just stand and declare the things that God declares over my life. Hebrews chapter 13 says, because the Lord has said, I will never leave you and never forsake you. I can boldly say, the Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. When God says something, you can then boldly declare it. Because he is the fulfiller of his word. He honors his word above his name. So he won't let his word fail you today. So come on, let's make some declarations. I want you to declare over your household today, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. I just declare to the heavens and to the earth today, Jesus is Lord over my home. He's Lord over my family. He's Lord over my spouse, my husband, my wife, my children. Come on, call your children by name. Just declare, Jesus, you're the Lord over my children today. I thank you, Father, that my children shall be taught of the Lord. Come on, just say that. My children shall be taught of the Lord, and great shall be their peace. I just declare over my spouse, my husband, or my wife today, that they shall walk in the blessings of the Lord, that they are blessed and highly favored, that God is for them and not against them. I just declare today over my finances, according to Philippians chapter 4, verse number 19, that my God shall supply all of my need according to his riches and glory in Christ Jesus. So I declare today I am well supplied. I have everything I have need of. I declare according to Isaiah 54, verse 17, no weapon formed against me today can prosper. And every tongue that rises against me I shall vindicate, for that's my heritage as a servant of the Lord. According to Romans 8:31, today, if God be for me, who can be against me? Come on, just make this declaration according to Philippians chapter 4, verse number 13. I can do all things through Christ Jesus who strengthens me. I want you to say today, God is with me. Nothing is impossible. I just declare over you today, there is no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus who walk after the Spirit but not after the flesh. I declare today that his kingdom is an everlasting kingdom of which there shall be no end. Lord, we just declare our faith today. I thank you that our city is being invaded by your Spirit and by your power. Wherever you live right now, I just want you to call for a move of God on your city. Begin to believe that God is going to touch your church where you worship. Pray for those that are in authority over you right now. Come on, just begin to pray for your pastor and for your elders, your leaders, God, we bless them today. We declare our faith over them today that you're a mighty God in their life. They're going to lead us into the fullness of the kingdom of God. Lord, we pray for those that are national leaders today. Whatever nation you're in, pray for them right now. Lord, I pray for my leaders today. For righteousness exalts a nation, but sin's a reproach to any people. So Lord, we declare we are people of faith and we're people of righteousness, and our nation shall be taught of the Lord. Thank you, Father, that we're coming from small influence to great influence because this kingdom is growing. We thank you that Jesus is becoming famous in the earth. Come on, friend, would you just lift your voice? Jesus wants to be made famous today wherever you go. So would you just realize today he's bigger than all my problems. He's bigger than all my troubles. He's bigger than all my fears. He's greater than anything I face today. I just declare my faith. I just want to pray for you according to Joshua chapter 1, verse number 8 and 9. Today, in order for you to walk into your promised land, God says you must be strong and of a good courage. So I just speak strength into you today. During this prayer time, you don't even realize it, but they that wait upon the Lord renew their strength. They mount up with wings as eagles. They run and don't grow weary. They walk and don't faint. You have been strengthened in this prayer time today. Be strong and of a good courage. I speak courage to you today. You'll have the courage to say no to what you need to say no to and yes to what you need to say yes to. Come on, just declare this with me today. Just say it out loud. I have courage today in Christ. I can do everything God's called me to do. I can be who God's called me to be. I can fulfill the purpose for which I was created. I am who God says I am. As we get ready to declare today that we're going to rise and shine, Isaiah 60 says, arise and shine. Why? Because your light has come and the glory of the Lord has risen upon you. I just speak this over you today. According to Psalms 102, verse 13, the set time to favor Zion has come. Today is your day for God's favor to be upon your life. Today is your day to shine forth with the beauty of the Lord. I declare that over you in Jesus' name. Let's just sing. Let's just declare. Let your voice be heard. God, you're a mighty God. There's nobody like you in all the world. Let's worship the Lord together. Let's arise and see Jesus in all of his glory.